Hey everyone, the name is Eric Dohr, and in today's video we will be taking a personality test, namely an Enneagram test. I've developed my own Enneagram test, and in this test you will be exploring your personal emotions, how you relate to your emotions, how you relate to your instincts, how you attach and connect with others, and how you feel about yourself. I am making and setting off on a whole new wave of work in this new upcoming book, The Power of Persona. I tend to think a lot about how I can come across better to other people. Disagree. I often worry that I have accidentally offended someone. Disagree. I tend to be afraid of losing my security. Disagree. I tend to withdraw or pull away when I am angry with others. Somewhat agree. Actually agree. I will want to help other people even if they don't let me. No, I won't. And that's been a problem with the two I've had for a long time. I enjoy taking risks based on ideas and possibilities. Yes. I am not afraid to speak up when something is wrong. Disagree. I don't know if I deserve to be this happy. Somewhat agree. I can be sometimes obstinate and reckless when standing up for myself. Somewhat agree. I don't know what's right or wrong anymore. Disagree. I'm ready to push myself to my limits to prove myself to the people who don't believe in me. Somewhat disagree. I am somewhat afraid and ashamed of the powers and abilities I possess. Somewhat disagree. I am very persistent about my goals and my aspirations. Agree. Strongly agree. I tend to excuse or pretend to not see bad behavior in other people. Somewhat agree. I am constantly afraid that I am missed to account for something important. Disagree. People think I am cold, but I am only trying to help them. Somewhat disagree. I am very thankful for what I have and wish for other people to have what I have too. Somewhat agree. I tend to rush through assignments so that I can go have fun. Somewhat disagree. I am very work-oriented. I know what people need to do to feel better. Somewhat agree. Agree. Fine. I can see every viewpoint, which tends to leave me feeling confused. Somewhat agree or agree. I have strong opinions, but I'm sometimes accused of contradicting myself. Somewhat agree. I am courageous to the point of being reckless. I would somewhat disagree here. I tend to doubt everyone, including myself. Strongly disagree. I feel little interest in intervening in the world around me unless I'm forced to. Yeah, some would agree. I work hard to support others and I become upset when they don't appreciate it. Some would agree. I believe in setting aside your values to make the impartial decision. Disagree. I spend a lot of time rationalizing my fears. Some would agree. I am brave, but I'm unlikely to spend time on conflicts. Somewhat disagree. I will often deny or brush over flaws in the people I care about. Somewhat agree. I tend to assume everything is great until it isn't. Somewhat agree. I will pretend to be certain and to know the answer even though I am confused. Somewhat disagree. If others try to change or critique me, I will often become obstinate. Disagree or agree. Okay, fine, agree. I can be happy and satisfied under Spartan-like conditions. Strongly agree. People say I can be somewhat vague and inconsistent when explaining my ideas. Somewhat agree. I am afraid of people noticing how odd I am. I've had that. I become anxious because I fail to live up to my high ideals. I would agree. So, here we have it. Here we have it. Enneagram 9, the creator, at the top. The self-preserving instinct, the magician, second. The tree, the performer, as you see right now. The four, also quite high. The sexual tendency, the lover, quite high. So here we see a pattern, a clear pattern. As a nine, I tend to be able to consider and see different possibilities, and I've always related a lot to the two, but as you see, the two is not very high in here at the moment. And this is probably a change within myself, but it's also realizing that some of the things I thought was Enneagram 2, some of the things I thought was being a helper and wanting to do good, was sometimes just wanting to have peace and to have a resolution to conflict and to be able to mediate. And in politics and in life in general, I have often sought this mediating, creative role where you have to see everyone's way of thinking, where you have to understand how people think and how people see the world, and to provide answers. Looking deeper, I also relate a lot to the magician archetype of the self-preserving type, and I kind of admire that state. I admire people that have that quality. Here I describe the magician as a self-preserving type, typically focused on themselves and a life away from the world. The magician is a non-interventionist, someone who prefers to watch from a distance and to not intervene with or disrupt the normal flow of the world. The magician will typically only act when they fear that their home or the things they care for are threatened. The magician is self-satisfied and trusts in their own ability and the powers they possess. However, their shame over past mistakes and some abuse of their own powers may leave them somewhat inhibited. They fear their own powers and they fear using their powers in the wrong way. And so they act more like a chess player, planning their moves carefully, using their power with care and conscience, and ensuring they are in full control of their powers at all times. And we have finally the tree, the kind of anxious hard worker, driven to prove themselves to their loved ones through hard work and through gaining a high income or accomplishing some kind of feat. Performers are typically driven to place themselves in situations that are far outside their personal comfort zone. I agree a lot with that. So, as you might have noticed here, there are some changes and additions that I make to the Enneagram theory. For example, I integrate the instincts and I redevelop the instincts and I bring into light new ideas about the instincts and how we can use them. Because I've often found that the instincts are hard to use and hard to assess and to understand, especially their relationship to the normal Enneagram types. The way I put them and place them is as opposites of the gut types in a sense. I talk about the instincts as relating to how we attach ourselves to other people and how we connect to others. We have the every person, the social orientation of the person that wants to fit in and to be a part of the group and to be normal. We have the sexual type, the lover, the person that drives themselves to and has a tendency to idealize their partners and the things they love and to compromise themselves too much to fit the expectations and needs of the ones they love. There are opportunities to learn here about how you form attachments to other people and to reflect on your personal patterns in relationships and in life in general. And I believe that instincts can teach us just as much about ourselves and our emotions as the existing 9 Enneagram types can. And what you might also notice is how I bring in Jungian archetypes into the Enneagram. I mold together Jungian perspectives with the Enneagram. I show how Jung's 12 existing archetypes, the ruler, the innocent, the lover, fit together with your personal Enneagram. And I show that Jung was already ahead of his time when he talked about these 12 existing personas. He was already aware of how we use personas and how we use masks and these archetypes to get power to do things that our normal personality type can't do on its own. And that is the final contribution I'm gonna make in this work, in these tests, in these articles. I am going to show how your personality type is affected by and expresses these archetypes. How an INFJ 1 differs from an INFJ 4. How an INFJ 9 differs from an ENFP 9. How these different strategies fit together and how your MBTI type, your flow type, your nature fits together with your Enneagram, your developed traumas, your past experiences in life, and your nurture. So that's all for today, guys. Take the test, have fun, and feel free to share your results in the comments down below. The Power of Persona is a Neo-Jungian perspective on the Enneagram and on Jung's 12 archetypes. It is a book to discover yourself, to pursue and learn growth, and to learn how to be healthy within your existing core personality type.